it's the day after the British Grand Prix. Thankfully, there's no rain, and we're here to ride this. This is the Triumph's test bike, which they've used to develop their Moto2 engine, which we'll see on the grids next year. So the engine in this is what's special. So this is a 765 engine that we've seen this year and last year in the street triple range. And they've developed this a little bit for racing, so they've bumped power up from 123 to what they say is more than 135 horsepower. And they've done that with a few quite simple ways. So first off, they've done a little bit of work on the head, so the head flows more gas and runs a slightly higher compression. It's got a full aero exhaust system, which is really loud. It really makes the hairs on the back of your neck stand up. It's running standard airbox and standard injection, but it's also running injectors that flow more fuel because obviously there's greater demand. And it's going to be really interesting taking this thing for a spin today. It's a beautiful machine with a few sort of chassis modifications to help it handle the power. So compared to a standard Daytona 675, which is what the chassis is based on, it's running KTEC fork internals, a KTEC shock. It's running lightweight OZ Racing magnesium wheels and Moto2 slicks, which are a lot more useful today than they would have been yesterday when the British Grand Prix was rained off. I'm really looking forward to seeing what it's like. I've just finished my day with the Triumph Moto2 development bike. It's been really interesting. We managed to get 10 minutes on the bike, which is quite a long time, and I was able to uncover quite a lot about it. It's going to be very interesting seeing how it goes on the grid next year. We've got a bike that develops a huge amount of bottom end and mid-range power. It's very different from the CBR 600RR machines that we've seen Moto2 at the moment. It's less peaky, it's going to drive out of corners, it's going to mean that gear selection is going to be less important. There'll be some riders that will be in second, some riders that will be in third. There'll be lots of interesting things going on like that, which will really sort of spice it up, and it'll mean that different riding styles can be applied as well. The motor itself is so impressive in the way that it makes power, in the way that it will drive in the mid-range, and it means that if one day Triumph decide to make another Daytona and they make a Daytona 765, they've got the perfect basis here. Let's hope they do.